Hey, how you doing? It's Manly Butch coming at you hot. How's it going? What's happening in your neck of the woods? I am just chilling here at home tonight and kicking back. I just finished mowing the lawn, trying to relax and do a little writing. And thought I'd do a quick video. Here comes Nola. She's gonna walk right behind me any second now. She's gonna lay over there. There she is. Big old Noli Bully. I don't know where Lou is. Maybe outside. I just mowed her yard. So, and I'm about to smoke this Black and Mild cream cigar. And I really like these. And it's not going to come into focus for you, but Black and Mild cream, they're absolutely excellent. I really love them. Not that I smoke them all the time. I treat myself about once a week. Once or twice a week to a decent, alternative smoke to the cigarette, so. I really enjoy these Black and Mild creams. I enjoy about anything that's flavored. The creamy flavors I enjoy the most. Stuff like the vape products I use and stuff are cream. Fans blowing over my head, so it's making the smoke take off. But anyway, so what do you think? Scaramucci lasted 10 fucking days, man. You know, Trump and his administration are so fucked up. And I'm sorry if I talk a little funny. I got a new plate. I had lost the back teeth on top on both sides, so they gave me a partial plate. So I have this kind of retainer thing in my mouth that has back teeth on it and gives me back teeth, but it's my tongue just doesn't have a place to live right now. It takes a little while to get used to, they said, wearing, so I'm getting used to it. I have to wear it all the time, or if I take it out, then I just don't get used to it, so it's stupid, and it does help a lot. Looks a lot better. Got a full smile. Yeah, all the rest of them are real, you know, but I had to do those. Four, the two on each side, thought on the top, but yeah. So Scaramucci, man, I thought the little prick was entertaining, you know, as the speaker for sure, you know, as being as the House correspondent or whatever the fuck his title was. But he certainly was a vulgar bastard. Not that I am anywhere any better. I'm not one to talk about language at all, you know. So, you know, but when you're talking to the public, to the, when you're a government official, when you're somebody that kids are supposed to look up to, that when you're supposed to be setting an example, you know, I believe that you should probably, you just probably try to keep your language down, saying things like, you know, what's he, that's that asshole. I'm not Steve Bannon. I'm not trying to suck my own cock. That guy said that. He said that in an interview. You know, I mean, and calling, you know, the other dude, I can't remember all these people's names. They're switching medications. My head's a little wacko. You know, I'm forgetting words and stuff lately. I know it's a result of switching these meds up, but yeah, he called the other guy there a fucking paranoid schizophrenic. And to say those things right out loud in an interview is just uncalled for. You know, his language couldn't, and he needs to have some respect. These guys don't have any respect for each other, let alone have any respect for anybody in the country, you know. So it's really a shark infested place DC is, man. It's dog eat dog down there, and they're all wearing milkbone underwear, you know. I saw one really cool example online of a bingo board with all the names and Trump in the middle, you know. And you know, and they were marked sketching off who was out. You know, more people have resigned or been replaced so far than in history in any other administration, as far as, you know, being such turmoil like this. You know, friggin' Trump says it's not chaos. He held his first official full cabinet meeting today. 193 days in office, and the motherfucker has finally called a full official cabinet meeting. He had some sort of a partial cabinet meeting back in June, yes. But this was the first full official cabinet meeting over 6 months in office. You know, he doesn't know how to govern. Kelly's going to try to show him how. And that'll be really interesting. I think you're going to see a real battle royale between Trump and Kelly. You know, I think if right now, you know, hey, for right now, you know, Trump is got Kelly, General Kelly there that he put in as his new White House chief of staff. He's letting him have his way, but Trump's not going to be bossed around and told what to do, and Kelly's going to try to do that. So I don't think he's going to get very far. I really don't. You know, I don't. I think it's going to become a battle between Trump and Kelly, and Kelly's not going to like that Trump is tweeting, and Trump's not going to like that Kelly's going to tell him what to tweet. Yeah, it's good old, all fucked up here in the USA still, everybody. You know, and then we got this Korea thing going on. Korea firing off missiles. The United States firing off missiles. The United States flying planes over Korea. Korea getting pissed off. China getting pissed off. Japan's all upset. And the Russians kick out 700 United States diplomats. What did we think was going to happen when we put all those sanctions on the Russians? I thought they were going to say, hey, that's great. Let's invite more people over. No, I think it's great. Bring all the Americans home from Russia. We don't need any Americans over in Russia. We don't need any Russians here in America. So I say send all the Russian diplomats back to Russia too. They should be on the first fucking Boeing 747 out of here. You know, end the Russian-American ties completely. Well, make it like Cuba. Make it illegal to do business in Russia. Won't that piss Trump over off? Anyway, hey, everything's going all right. I'm hanging in there, and I don't know, I'm a little still wound up with the politics. I need a haircut, wicked bad, which is why I'm wearing the hat. I definitely need a big old haircut. It's all out of sync here, so that'll happen probably tomorrow. And you know, the weather's been really nice here. It's been very cool. It's been beautiful actually, in the 70s during the day, and not humid. But it's supposed to break tomorrow. It's supposed to start getting real hot again. Maybe time to take a dog to the beach. anyway, I hope you're having a great night. I'll talk to you all later. Peace.